Hey everybody, I'm Andrew Starks, Director of Product Management for Macnica Americas. At Macnica, we are really excited about AV over IP and open standards. Why? Because we believe that interoperable AV over IP has the power to transform both live video production and pro AV with exciting new workflows and applications that could really revolutionize the way we tell stories with video and audio. That is why I am excited to introduce the MPA1000 launch kit in this video. Now, the MPA1000 is a system on a module that can deliver 4K 60 444 video, audio, and control signals on a single 1 gigabit Ethernet connection with excellent quality. The MPA1000 is built using Macnica's ME10 system on a chip, which is available to high volume customers. And the MPA1000 launch kit is used to develop products with either component. Besides excellent quality, perhaps the most intriguing feature of the MPA1000 and ME10 is that they are designed from the ground up to support IPMX, which stands for Internet Protocol Media Experience. IPMX is an emerging open standard for AV over IP that is being developed by a small group of nonprofit standards organizations that together represent more than 100 member companies, each dedicated to keeping video technology open and accessible for everyone. Because it isn't controlled or owned by a single vendor, IPMX and the MPA1000 promise to deliver truly multi-vendor interoperable AV over IP that meets the needs of software and hardware developers, systems integrators, and end users. Some of the highlights include the new JPEG-XS codec, which gives the MPA1000 its excellent quality on a 1 gigabit network, even at resolutions up to 4K 60 with a 444 color space, which is perfect for delivering desktop displays. Subframe latency for interactive applications such as KVM, live production, and gaming. Support for HTTP 2.3. Independent routing of audio and video from different IP sources. Support for synchronous and asynchronous sources. A robust design that works on many network environments with optional PTP support and compatibility with low-cost network hardware. A REST API for network discovery and making connections. Each MPA can act as an IPMX sender or receiver, depending on the loaded image. And finally, the MPA1000 includes a fully featured, customizable web interface with full control over the module's features. Clearly, IPMX and the MPA1000 have what it takes, but we did mention that IPMX is an emerging set of standards, which means that some of these outstanding features are still being refined and developed. The good news is that the core set of AV over IP standards within IPMX have been battle-tested and broadcast for the better part of the last decade, forming an established, stable foundation of standards that includes SMPTE's ST2110 and AMWA's NMOS API. Even at this stage, IPMX is meeting requirements for a wide array of products, especially in live production. There is a ton of power and stability in IPMX, so it's no wonder that manufacturers around the world are planning and developing products for IPMX right now. Which begs the question, how do you get started? That's where the MPA1000 launch kit comes in. Thanks to the flexibility of the MPA1000's design, we are able to bring unique features online and keep pace with the standards as they are developed. Our customers receive free updates to our board support package, which means they can follow along with the changes, and better yet, get involved in the standards community. That means they'll be ready with IPMX solutions on the day the standard is launched, which is exactly why we created the MPA1000 launch kit, which includes just about everything you need to get going. The kit includes two MPA1000 modules and development boards, an 8-port switch with IGMP 2 capability, a NanoPi computer to host DHCP and NMOS registration, plus various cables and supplies to help support your development with the MPA1000. The MPA1000 launch kit really is the perfect on-ramp for IPMX, so let's take a look at how it works. First, we'll connect the components of the launch kit together, following the instructions in the Quick Start Guide. Next, let's log into the MPA1000's customizable web interface. Since this is the evaluation release, some of the functionality is more limited than what we'll see in the final product, but you can already see how easy it is to use. Right now, we're logged into the encoder, and you can see the decoder listed below. We'll click on the video icon, click the connect button, and that's it. 4K 60 video with low latency is almost instantly shown on my display through the launch kit, and it looks perfect. Obviously, there is a lot more to the MPA1000 and IPMX, which we'll cover in future videos. For now, head on over to macnicatech.com, where you'll find out more information. Also, we would welcome a chance to schedule a demonstration and discuss how the MPA1000 or ME10 will fit into your next product. Thank you for watching this video, and we hope to hear from you soon.